Jim, this was sent to CornyDriveThru at gmail.com from Blake Williamson. Hello, Mr. Cornette and Mr. Last. This question is coming to you from the great city of Richmond, Kentucky. Watching AEW Rampage Friday night, my father drew the comparison between Matt Hardy and Paul Jones, and I couldn't help but laugh. My question to you, Mr. Cornette, is do you think Matt Hardy is the modern-day Paul Jones with his faction of low-card guys? And if so, who did it better? My father and I love the show and watch it every week. Keep up the great work.
Well, Paul Jones, honestly, as far as who did it better, whose results were better, Paul Jones's were. Because at least he did have some recognized talent at some various points in his stable. And honestly, the program with Jimmy Valiant against all of his men did draw money because it was Jimmy Valiant and he was so fucking over.
That is a good point you have to point out, because you go back and you watch it and Paul Jones is a horrible manager and he has just the most ridiculous fucking stable and Jimmy Valiant looks like shit. However, Jimmy Valiant was super fucking over.
So
That's the reason it actually worked. Jimmy Valiant was, you could say almost like him and Orange Cassidy in different dimensions in terms of their role on the show. But Jimmy Valiant was actually over, really super over. Go watch Jimmy Valiant 83. It's ridiculous.
Yeah. And see, at that time, he'd been in the business 20 years. He was in his early to mid 40s. And I mean, he'd been a bodybuilder. Look at that handsome Jimmy Valiant and those fucking arms and that chest in the early 70s and et cetera. And he had gone through so many iterations of his gimmick. And he had, you know, he had lost weight when he had health issues and then he had bulked back up. But at that point, he'd realized it's the promo and it's the gimmick. And I mean, Jimmy Valiant used to take big bumps, big backdrops. They weren't all textbook perfect, but as a heel in the 60s and 70s, he did that. He didn't need to do any of that then. But he was over like crazy because the gimmick and the promos and the personality. So for people who wondered why we're comparing Paul Jones to Matt Hardy, Paul Jones was a big name in the Carolinas, in Georgia, in Florida, for 15 years as a wrestler. And he had been on top and held numerous championships. But at that time, he was in his, even mid to late 40s at that point. And he had a bad back, and he had transitioned to managing. And Paul Jones, his strength had never been his promos to begin with, but he was better as a wrestler and as a heel, especially himself. But when he tried to be a heel manager, it's a different art form. And he wasn't a good one at it. And he had a name because of his wrestling background, but as a manager, it was fucking rough. And so Dusty kept all of the because Paul Jones and Jimmy Valiant was the feud, and Jimmy wasn't going to have any really good matches in ring at that point, so Jimmy wasn't going to be fucking wrestling the Horseman. But he was so over, Dusty concocted the thing with him and Paul Jones and just had Jimmy wrestle all of Paul Jones's guys, and that it was all contained in that match on the card, Jimmy Valiant versus Paul Jones's army. And, you know, you got what you got in the ring, but it drew money. Here's the problem. Matt Hardy, like Paul Jones, was a big name as a wrestler and has not transitioned well as a manager because it's a different art form. But they've given Matt Hardy nobody of any repute whatsoever to manage. And he ass backwarded his way into it after Matt had also been, remember it, Matt came in teleporting as the broken Matt Hardy or the woken Matt Hardy. Then Matt Hardy got brain damage. Then Matt Hardy became himself 1 week. And then he became something else. And then he transitioned to be a manager that was stealing the guy's money from him. But then they signed up with him anyway. So he's been through about five or six different personalities. His guys are unproven and certainly not at the level of a guy like the Barbarian, who was a pretty fucking, you know, a decent fucking name in the 80s. And instead of a guy that's super over that can draw money, he's being programmed in this case against the guy who's super over because he's the boss's favorite wrestler and he's like a little mascot. And people watch him on TV because they like to laugh at phony wrestling, but they're never going to buy a ticket to see this fucking guy in any major numbers. So I think Paul Jones did it better because the programs drew money and there were some recognized names involved. And Jimmy Valiant had been a major name in the wrestling business for 20 years at that point, even if he was not at the best of his physical peak at that time. Go ahead.
And hopefully they don't copy the Jones-Valiant feud in that it went on for like 5 years. Hopefully that's one thing they don't copy. But I do think it's a fair comparison. Matt Hardy is like the Paul Jones. His stable is the Jones Army. And then the best friends are like Jimmy Valiant, Lasertron, and Bugsy McGraw.